Yeah. So I'm here with Lister, who's the dark haired boy, and Kat. And neither of them want the yogis until they're down the top. Anyway. I should really start doing my makeup in a different room because they don't like the bright light in here, do you, boy? No, not to go down. But then, you can go into hiding. See if you'll take it now. Here you go. So, and the other one. Here you go. No, you can't go around there. Come here. In fact, I think I'll just take him out of the bottom and put him in my hood. You're causing problems wanting to explore. I thought you were wanting away because you were scared and instead you just want to explore. You're a naughty boy. Go on, in you go. Well, we'll see what happens with that. So, to save some time, I've already used the Touch Glorious Face Primer, which is a clear gel, and it feels like velvet on the skin and it gives you a lovely base for your foundation. And I've used the Moonstruck Eye Primer, which gives you a lovely base for your eyeshadow. So, I'm going to be brave, and I'm going to try the new way of putting eyeshadow on, which is totally alien to me, putting on eye colour before makeup, which is just weird. So I'm going for a bright green. I think that colour will go quite well with the shade I got from Unique. Hooded eyes, which means I've got to put the makeup up higher into a sort of a dome shape, otherwise it just disappears behind the hood of my eye. Where are you going? Are you attracted to all the bright colours down here, eh? You're going to give me ratty footprints in my makeup. Of course, it's getting to that time of day, it's 4:45, so they'll be starting to wake up now. So that's fairly dramatic. He's okay. He's just sitting on my hip. I've never ever done it like this before. But that's what everybody says you should be doing. Go in. You see, for me, I've got these dark circles, and surely it's going to be difficult to cover this when you've got this is a sort of a bronze colour for the middle of the eye. It's by De Bruyere. Such a soft point in it that it's just went everywhere. I'll be honest with you, I really don't know what I'm doing. I've seen a splurge of this shade and I think I quite like it. But I thought I would try out. I've had this sitting in my makeup box unused for a long time, probably years. So I thought I would try it out from here first. Okay, so now we go in with the concealer. No, it's foundation first. I'll still be using my concealer brush. And this is the Touch Mineral Concealer, which is in Vela. But it's actually got a little bit of the light shade Scarlet mixed in as well, because Vela was just a tiny bit too dark for me. And there's two new light shades, Tulle and Lace, and I'm quite excited to see in what colour they'll be. You're never too old to learn new tricks. Definitely more active now, aren't they? You stay up here, Kat. You have to want to explore. Better if you stay up here. We have a little Yorkshire Terrier who's coming up 15 years old, and I'm sure he wouldn't bother with him, but at the same time I'd rather not risk it. He likes to follow us around, so I know that he's just outside the door. You having fun? Of course I'll have the smell of the other rats that I've from the other cage. I've had rhubarb and custard out, so you'll be able to smell them, won't you? And that's what rhubarb custard did to me. I kept trying to take them out because just to have a wee look at them, but they weren't happy. So that's my foundation on, which went on actually a lot easier than I thought it would. And now for my concealer. There it is. Dutch Mineral Skin Perfecting Concealer. I'm sure you'll have heard me sing its praises before, but it really is wonderful. I thought I had a brush for that, but I don't seem to have brought it through. But I don't think I've used this brush yet. I normally use my fingertips, but I keep being told that, well, I should use a brush, so here goes with a brush. Sorry, boy, I'm not letting you walk all over my makeup. And I was also told to put a little under my brow. Oh, this is very new. Too much there. Yeah, monkey. Oh, I think I made a right mess there, haven't I? Blending brush. Okay. Is that how it's supposed to look? Now it's blister that's coming down onto my makeup table. He's not got very far yet, thankfully. You sniffing? Sniffy sniff. Unix brush cleaner is also pretty amazing, so I don't mind using an eyeshadow brush a couple of times for this. You pair are terrible. I probably want in my pocket. Yeah, I've got another couple of treats here. So I'll leave that there. And the next time they come, I'm armed. Armed and dangerous. So I've done these three makeup looks in one day because I'm feeling pretty good today. And I don't know when I'll be feeling this good again, so I want to get some, well, I just want to have some fun. Yes, I wanted to have some fun. My beautiful little boy with his notched ear. And you're gorgeous. Yes, I am. Yes. Yogi. Cat. Where are you? Ah, looking at the wrong side. Here we go. Something else I've never used is a highlighter. So I think I'm supposed to powder first. So let's get this powder foundation set. This isn't the unique powder, I hope to get that soon. Yeah, I'm a bit of a geek. Okay. So before I put the highlighter on, I need to put the bronzer on. Once as I pick it up, I'll dab in there, which distributes it through the brush better. And then it's just a little bit on the cheekbone, under, slightly under, and up the side a little. And don't forget to go take it over to your ear. Otherwise, just the chrome. Doing that can help. Not that I soak in very much, but having one of those pudgy faces. So, highlighter, never used before. Apparently it was underneath the brow. In the right place, and it goes here, top of your cheekbone. You can tell me in the comments section if I'm getting this all wrong. You know, I'm just learning all this new. Your nose. And in the corner of your eye. Down here again, boy. Now, I've never tried contouring. What is he doing? I've got one of those fat old noses. Down the middle. And seemingly that's supposed to make my nose less huge. Right, boys. Stay up there for goodness sake. So what have I got left to do? Epic mascara, and I've just done the cardinal sin of pumping air in. I really don't do that, it dries out so much quicker. And if you're having trouble getting your mascara out, you're supposed to roll it to warm it, and you stir the brush around rather than going like that. tends to be a lot of the time why I wear dip and draw liner. It's to cover up the liner mess I've made. So that's one coat in there. It's quite a nice difference. I'll pick my eyes up. I'll quickly draw my brow in. I really love the eyebrow pencil because it's a very fine point, which means you can basically draw it here. I naturally don't have hairs along this side, about halfway along they go away, and that's to do with a thyroid issue. Also, you shouldn't really panic if your eyebrows aren't totally matching. I never get mine the same. And to be honest, I'm not that bothered. Waterline white. I think this is Pristine. Yeah, Pristine Moodstrap Precision Pencils. And once these are on, they stay on forever, so they're great. Very soft as well, so they're easy to apply. And as I said in my other video, I've misplaced my black, so I'm having to use an old one from a different brand that really isn't as good. It's a lot harder. Goes on like season, especially for tight lining. I need to move forward for this. I know. I just like my hair. You want an attention? You just want to explore today, don't you? I'm a wee explorer. I'm not really sure how well I look with browns and greens goes with purple hair, but we can make it work. Look at that, what a difference. From my very short lashes, I am using the growth serum. I've been using it for 2-3 weeks. I do see a difference, not so much in the length but in the volume of hairs. Yeah, there's definitely more hair there. I'm so glad. What was it I did when I ripped them out? I got them stuck on something and I ripped them out, remember? I think it was not so long ago I ripped a whole bunch of them out. Don't you hate when that happens? I always get stuff under my under eyes. I'm going to buy some of those shields. In fact, I might have some more red. That would be just like me to have more red and not be using them. Right. So, not 100% sold, but it is quite nice. I'm speaking quite a lot, so my throat's going groggy. Better or worse. Probably worse. Blendy, Blendy. Where's Mr. Blendy gone? Well, that looks more even now. Quick dip and draw. Just a thin line. And in fact, I think we're running out of time, so I'll put my makeup on, my lipstick on. Again, isn't a unique. But you don't have to have everything unique, you just mix and match with what you've got. I hope to one day. So, that's a more natural look, and I've tried a lot of new things. And I think it's alright. I've never had a shine up there. I was always told after 40 you don't shine. You stick to matte, but I actually quite like that. If anyone has any tips or comments or help, I think I've made a mess of a bit of it. But I'm certainly trying and I'm certainly learning, and it's fun, it's lots of fun. And I'll finish my eyes off and whatever else, and take some photos, and I'll add them up later on. So, thanks.